Hey, good afternoon. Thanks for joining us right here on Midday Kentucky. Before we get the show started, I want to know who went over to our Midday Kentucky Facebook page yesterday and saw the funny video I put on there. Well, you put it on, you videoed it, of me pretending to be Katie doing a marathon over in Paris. If you were watching yesterday, we talked about Amsterdam. Same thing. No, it's not. We talked about it yesterday, and you know, I did a little skit to Chariots of Fire. And please go over and mocking you. It was very funny. It was very. I was very clever.
It was cute.
Even
was
you laughed out
I did,
loud.
I did.
And even you said, "This is so wrong."
Yes, I did.
But I also want to say, tell us what you think. We were sitting in our production meeting, and as you all know, we've talked about it many times. I come from the beauty field back home in Australia, and I was suggesting that me and a makeup artist and a team that I will bring in live on the show. We're going to do the whole show. My producer's about to flip in the control room right now because he doesn't know about this. We're going to have the whole show set this up like a salon, okay, the whole set of Midday Kentucky. Both these gals are going to come in makeup free. We're going to do their makeup from top to toe, and I'm going to do all their hair. Okay. So it looks like we're doing a makeover, but we're going to do the whole show just like we would normally do. We're going to do table talk. It's just like a salon. So okay. I'll be saying to you about this topic, oh, Katie, did you hear blah, 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 whilst I'm curling your hair and you're having your makeup put on, we will discuss.
Okay.
So we're going to show you how we can do a makeover in 45 minutes.
And do a table talk and type show.
No, and
too,
we're going
right?
to do interviews. We'll bring guests in. I don't know whether it's a bald eagle. Do you know what I mean? But we'll have to work that out. Do you like that idea?
I like that idea.
Yeah.
We could go for some hair tips from you.
We could do some hair tips. We could do some makeup tips. And I might even organize some of our sponsors to give away some nice beauty things on the day as well.
Wow.
Make it a fun day. What do you reckon?
You
said to me, I don't want to bring my face in here without makeup or without my hair done.
We might lose viewership on this. I'm just telling you right now. But I will do it. I will take one for the team.
Well, the reason why I came up with this, Katie complained this morning. I was doing Good Day Kentucky. And she was had her hair head upside down, spraying it. Then I look over and here she is brushing it all out again. I said, what are you doing brushing your hair? It looked great. She said, you know what? You never give me advice. You never help me.
No, I said you always critique me and you never help me. So he always tells me what's wrong with my hair, but I don't know how to make it look better.
Well, I did help you to begin with because you used to wear it straight and almost one length.
Yeah.
And then you had that funny thing you used to shove in there. What was it, the hairpiece?
I said you had. I still have it.
Yeah. Is it in there now? No, it's not, you fib.
No.
You're telling me a fib. I would have ripped it out of your hair so fast. Do you know what I mean? Like, it was like having a, you know, a horse tail on a head. There was so much hair there. Do you know what I mean? But anyway, we're going to have some fun with it. Are you ready to kick off the show?
Let's do it.
Let's do it, my friends. Henna body art has been a celebratory tradition in many countries for centuries. But as it grows in popularity, more and more people are being exposed to black henna dye, which can cause serious side effects. This looks perfectly fine, right? Mm-hmm. A young British girl is the latest victim of a bad reaction to the actual henna. 7-year-old Madison was on vacation in Egypt with her mother.
Oh.
And, you know, when she got the tattoo, everything seemed okay. But when she got home, back to England, this is what happened.
Oh, no.
Her skin blistered.
Oh, that's horrible.
Is this an allergic reaction?
Allergic
or
reaction to henna.
Chemicals?
Now, here's the thing. Henna is supposedly a natural product. Now, back in the day, there was a lot of conversation about henna hair dye and things like that. I don't know whether you ever heard of that. And you used to mix it up with water, okay, hot water, and you used to put it on your hair. And supposedly, it had a lot of aluminium base in it.
Which means what?
Well, it's not great for the hair.
Okay.
But people say it was, okay? So I don't know the ingredients of henna, but here's the thing. I always thought that doing this henna dyes, something like this would happen. Do you remember, I think you were away, I talked about that other lady in England that had the bad
yes,
eyebrows.
Yeah.
Doing a test patch. If you're going to go out and have a henna tattoo done for a wedding or fun, have a test patch, guys, mm-hmm. because this is what happens.
Yeah.
Well, I think that you also end up getting it from companies that are not as reputable. You see, when you
That's
go
correct.
On spring break, there's someone just kind of on a corner doing henna tattoo.
Right.
I wouldn't really do. You don't know what they've mixed it with. Maybe they've diluted it to make it last longer.
Right.
But I've also had wonderful cultural experiences with henna, like Indian
yeah.
weddings that I've been to and things like that. And that's very high quality, done by professionals
mm-hmm.
who know. They look at your skin before you have it done. But it scares me, these little kids getting it done.
Wow.
And you're just at the beach. You know those spring break type locations?
Yes, yeah.
And they do them for little mm-hmm. girls and stuff. That's kind of scary.
It is.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know how that's regulated.
Well, this is really interesting. Well, I can tell you that now. They were just saying here, the data says 5.5% of patients, I know that doesn't seem a lot, who actually had a patch test, mm-hmm. like I was suggesting, with a PPD, I'm not quite sure that who is, got allergic reaction from having the henna dye put on. It is interesting. I'm serious. These types
right.
of things can be serious if you don't take care of it. And I think with society nowadays, with us being so careful, our bodies aren't used to these things anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the day when you ate dirt for lunch.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, you build up an immune system.
You dropped your
system.
Apple and you ate it and
yeah.
kids did whatever.
Right.
Now they have a sniffle and their parents put them on antibiotics.
Right.
So
right.
their immune system's being dropped.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So we're opening ourselves up to these type of things. I just
yeah.
wanted to put it out there. This is also on our Facebook page, Midday Kentucky's Facebook page. Go on there, tell us if you have had any issues when it comes to allergic reactions
mm-hmm.
and maybe we can get someone to help you out as well. Let's talk about something that we don't have in Australia, but I found it interesting that it was a conversation here and talking about wearing white after Labor Day.
Yeah, what do you guys think? Is it appropriate to wear white after Labor Day or do you follow that rule?
Well, no, I'm new here, so you go for it, sister.
I do. I don't want to, but
right.
Doug kind of keeps me in check with that.
Well, what do you mean Doug keeps you in check?
He's all up on all the etiquette of clothing and when you're supposed to wear things and time of year and all of
oh.
that. He's very good with all that. And I just kind of fly by the seat of my pants half the time, so I just, you know.
Oh, we know
white.
That.
We do.
Well, I thought this was interesting. I was looking up online because I really had no idea why, you know, where did this stem from, not to wear white after Labor Day or before Memorial Day. And this was interesting that stems back from there are two basic rumors that
yep.
in the early 1900s, wealthy people, their summer was defined between Memorial and Labor Day, and wealthy people would always leave for their cottage or seaside home. And the only thing you would take with you is white. And they say to stay cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's one theory. And then the other is as it starts to get cold, coal comes out in your home and then you would get dirty and get soot on yourself.
Oh.
And that's where people say it came from in the early 1900s, but then they just say fashionistas jumped on the bandwagon and
yeah.
it has been the rule ever since. But there's also winter white.
Yeah, there is.
Actually, I was about to say to you, isn't there winter white linen?
There is.
Yeah.
There is. Well, I don't know about linen.
I don't know about linen.
Yeah, winter white linen that you can, like, it's a, like a cool fabric.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But then again, that could be me saying that about Australia again, because when it's your winter, it's our summer.
Yeah.
So I might be off on that.
Huh. So you follow that rule?
I try to, yeah.
Okay.
unless
but
I'm
you
really,
don't.
Unless my,
Look,
you know, if I'm down on clothing, I have no other choice.
Of
than
course.
If I haven't done the laundry.
Of course the fashionistas jump on it because it's another way to sell something else.
Right.
But I also think it's quite nice to have those little traditions,
mm-hmm.
you know, and there's nothing better than watching everyone turn up to an all-white party or,
mm-hmm.
you know, I love seeing women in white, pedal pushers, we used to call them, you know, the pants that go
oh,
three-quarter
okay.
down the
yeah.
leg
mm-hmm.
and a lovely heel
mm-hmm.
and a nice big hat. I love all that. I think it's very feminine.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it really is anything for men, is it?
No, they say men too.
Yeah.
And that's when it started. It was men cleaning the homes
oh.
with the coal. And they
oh.
would get the soot on themselves. So men also are supposed to put away the white.
Oh, well, speaking of men, my friend, Viagra drones. What the? Does that mean these drones will go all day? Is that what you're telling us?
They're going to go all day, all night. They're going to keep on going. But yeah, okay, so now, you know, we have drones that they're testing to deliver pizza. We've got them for delivering AEDs.
Doesn't Amazon deliver on the drones?
Well, they're
testing. Starting to.
Yes, they just had, matter of fact, that was mentioned in the article as well. But so now MedExpress is looking at having drones deliver medications to patients, and they have done the trials in the UK, and it was very successful. And you know, they can deliver Viagra, they can deliver the morning after pill, they can deliver anything.
Hold on, so it's interesting you say those two things. What my concern is here, what happens if it's delivered to the wrong address?
Well, that's, I mean, that's part of the concerns that people have, but they do have, they did state in there that they have blacked out, there's no information about what's in the container, the sales, or anything of that nature. But you're right, I mean, you know.
Well, that's even worse, I think.
Well, I don't
know if you want your neighbor seeing Viagra being delivered
right.
to your door.
Well, I think that's everyone, you know, has one in their pocket nowadays. Do you know what I mean? It's like, you know, I don't know.
I don't either.
Just put that out there, we don't.
No, but here's my concern with that, is I don't have an issue with all that sort of stuff. You know, it's technology, it's gonna happen. But I think they need to think about it a little bit more.
Right.
Because my concern is, let's just say I'm your neighbor, mm-hmm. and I'm expecting my pills to arrive, and so are you.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, human error, typing in the address, mm-hmm. just 116 or 118,
right.
blah, blah. I get yours, no description on there, mm-hmm. I just start taking my heart pills, mm-hmm. but all of a sudden I realize they're Doug's Viagra,
mm-hmm.
and how do
right.
I know?
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, they're going to definitely have to, it's still in the trials, obviously.
Not saying that Doug does that. Do you know what I mean? I just thought I better recoil that, like push that back
yeah.
in my mouth, Troy.
You're going to get a call
yes,
later on.
Yes, I know. I just thought about that. What do you think?
I don't know. I think that the human error would be just as likely in a pharmacy. You know, they accidentally put the wrong pills in your bottle or mm-hmm. something like that. And I don't think that happens very often. And I think that they were saying there's nothing to script on the outside of it. But once you would open it, it would be the prescription bottle.
Right.
That would have the
exactly. So just the packaging
it's just
for
it. It was more for privacy, so people don't see what's being delivered.
Did
to
you
your
explain
home.
That properly?
Probably
I understood
not,
it.
But she
I
understood, so, you know. But I'll go into more detail for some
We would
people.
Like that because our viewers might have been on the same
you're right,
wavelength
you're
as
right,
me.
You're right.
But did you understand it? So
well, I understand. That's why I was clarifying.
Thank you. Thank you, Katie.
We appreciate a half-baked story.
Troy!
Okay. It's 116 days till Christmas, and one mother has gone on a furious rant at shops for starting Christmas preparations way too early after finding cards in stock in August. Now, this was all over Mumsnet. It went crazy. Do you think August is too early for Christmas buying or Christmas information? That's an image in the UK, obviously, by the way.
I think it's smart to buy presents throughout the year and store them away, and you know, when there's sales going on and whatnot.
Yeah.
But actually buying Christmas cards and things like that, no, I'm not at that point in my mind. I'm, you know, gearing up for Halloween, really. I mean, that's kind of where my head is kind of starting
really?
To go.
And
yeah.
Thanksgiving, Halloween and Thanksgiving.
Halloween, for sure. Just trying to get ideas for the costumes and stuff like that. So, and I just saw some Halloween items
really?
At the store. Yeah, they were all, Kroger had it all decked out, so.
It's a lot to think about.
I don't know, it doesn't bother me at all. If it's fun
well,
and
you're
people
Jewish, do you celebrate Christmas?
No, but then I would be, by that argument, even more bothered by all the extra Christmas stuff.
Okay.
It just doesn't bother me. It's if you want your Christmas cards in August, or you want to start looking forward to something that you know you look forward to or enjoy. I'm personally not stocking up on Christmas cards in August, but
yeah,
I just it doesn't bother me
you
at all.
You know what I would like to do? Give us your suggestion. Head over to our Facebook page on Midday Kentucky, and give your suggestions on where I would like to do a photographic picture for Christmas cards. I've always wanted to do it.
A what?
Like,
a what?
You know when they take a picture and it's it's an image of you on a Christmas
yeah,
card?
Yeah, you can do that
yeah.
at Walmart.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you're the queen of Walmart. Okay. Can we?
Yeah, you can do it at Target
yeah.
as well.
Yep.
Yeah. I think you can do it at Meijer, too.
What about
yes,
Meijer?
You can.
Yeah, Meyer, you can.
But we should do that. Yeah. That would be very funny, everyone. Hey, guys, up next we will chat with Clark Regional Medical Center about how we can keep our children healthy, well, your children and your children, not our children, healthy for the new school year. Keep it right here. You're watching Midday Kentucky.